Live from Cullman, Alabama, Premier Bank presents Wake Up Cullman.
Morning, everyone. I'm Jacob Murphy.
I'm Natalie Bonner.
And again, everyone here welcomes you to another episode of Wake Up Cullman. So how are you this morning?
I'm awesome. How are you?
You know, I am here. I am breathing. I am blessed. Therefore, I'm having a good day so far.
Great. Well, we know it's Monday and everyone's kind of dragging a little bit, and myself included.
Everyone's dragging.
Dragging, yeah, we're all dragons, didn't you know? Sorry, I'm on a Game of Thrones kick.
See, we've ruined her just like everyone else.
Yeah, if you are feeling like me though, you might be just a little bit under the weather. So, you know, as we continuously say, get ready for that fall weather, which will eventually turn into winter, and break out the coats. I actually had to wear my coat this morning.
I didn't, but it's because I was ill-prepared because I don't pay attention until it's too late.
Well, that sounds like your problem.
It is my problem. It's my problem and many other Americans' problem because we don't watch the weather.
Well, in local news, Dr. Craig Ross, he's the Cullman County Schools superintendent. He actually spoke at the Cullman Area Chamber of Commerce's community luncheon, which was really packed out. And he was speaking about the new face of education and about all of the different goals that he has for the Cullman County school board system. So watching, you know, everyone listen to him and everything was a wonderful experience. We're really happy that everyone came out for that. And, you know, it's exciting to watch Dr. Ross put these changes into effect.
Absolutely. And, you know, some other very interesting community events happened over the weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Saturday hosted Farm Y'all.
Yes, Farm Y'all did happen. It actually had one of its largest turnouts. We always have a good turnout for Farm Y'all, but this year was especially exciting, plus the rain held off, which was really nice.
Right up until Saturday night, and then it bottomed out. And then it also showed the Scam Jam and the Health Fair happened this weekend. The BBB hosted that, and that was another wonderful event that was brought to our community. I did not personally get to go, and I apologize for that, but I did have a lot of people that I knew that went, and they all enjoyed it. They said they had a lot of very interesting people to meet there.
Definitely, and the Scam Jam and Health Fair, it was such an informative free workshop as well. Mm-hmm. So we're very grateful that the Cullman community has those type of programs that they offer. So thank you to everyone that came out this weekend in support of all of our different events.
Definitely. And, you know, you'll have to tell us how you went because, again, I sadly didn't get to go like I'd like to.
Well, next time we'll just have to drag you out.
Absolutely. Definitely. All right. Well, every day we like to talk to you about some of the things that our sponsors have been nice enough to give us to then give you. So let's take a look at what some of those items are today. Alrighty, well, we can get a Bojangles free sausage biscuit. And Mad Dog Mike's free family barbecue pack. That's a pound of meat, 2 16-ounce sides, and 4 buns. And the Chick-fil-A Choose Your Treat. That's a small cone or a chocolate chip cookie. So remember, definitely check the Facebook page, see who the sponsor of the day is, and call us in at 256-734-7399. That's 256-734-7399. Do not miss your opportunity to win those awesome prizes.
And our Facebook friend of the day is going to be Wayne Roberts, and he actually likes James Spann and Yorkies. So we are going to give him a Mad Dog Mike's Famous Barbecue Sandwich for being our friend on Facebook.
Yorkies.
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 Yeah.
And we're not kidding. That's what it said, was Yorkies.
Well, we have an exciting guest coming up. We have Cherie and Alicia from Backstage Boutique. So if y'all are wondering where all those Cullman girls are getting all of their cool clothes from, stay tuned and we'll let you find out, okay?
Overwhelmed by home refinancing offers from telephone solicitors and direct mail advertising, and then find you're not qualified for a specific plan? The Mortgage Center, a hometown lender, compares the rates from all home loan lenders and the qualifications of the various government programs to find a plan best suited to you. The Mortgage Center helps Cullman County people purchase and refinance their homes.
This is Pat Moody. Call us today and let us tailor a loan program to your specific needs and requirements.
I'm Jay Mullins with Premier Bank.
And I'm Jacob Mullins.
For more than 26 years, we've been providing friendly personal banking services to the citizens of Cullman and surrounding counties. We continue to provide new and improved services to our customers, and we even have a new look. So come by and see us at any of our 9 convenient locations. And remember, the same friendly personal service, and we're open on Saturdays.
With classic bolognese behind you, there are racks of lamb ahead. There are tartlets to take on and crazy knife skills to perfect. There is you and your Muse, the appliance brand more chefs choose. Chefs choose KitchenAid for their homes more than any other brand. And when every machine does incredible things, there's so much more to make.
Everybody, and we are back. We have Miss Cherie and Alicia from Backstage Boutique with us today. Thank you guys for joining.
Thanks for having us.
Absolutely. I know it's a Monday. People are tired. They need their coffee. But you know what? We're so excited to have y'all on the show. Now, can you tell us about how Backstage Boutique came to be?
Well, I've been selling clothing at my hair salon in Eva for years and years. I've never advertised it or anything. And my daughter and I, her name's Latessa, she owns it with me. We opened a business in Irondale for about a year, and we wanted it closer home because she and another lady, Sybil Zucala, managed it for us in Birmingham, so they're here and have helped us here. And it's just been a dream we wanted to do, and we like to dress, and we like, it's like playing Barbie dolls, I guess.
Yeah.
they're so small, you can tell. So
That's awesome.
We just enjoy going and just the adventure of hand selecting our fashions for our friends and ladies.
Yeah, that sounds really fun. Now, where did the name come from?
Well, we're our whole family's been involved in music and theater and stuff like that through the years, and Southern gospel music. We traveled for years, and my daughter, Latessa, has she was an extra on Melrose Place and several things like that we've lucked up on doing. And so that theme, we've got, like, my brother recorded on RCA and stuff like that. So we have a backstage theme there. Like, we try to look at it as a stage for our ladies to get dressed and be stage material, you know, out when they get out.
Yeah, I love that name.
So it's decorated with, like, movie films and records and themes from Hollywood and stuff like that.
Well, that sounds like a lot of fun. Awesome. Very, very cool. It sounds like it's got a cool vibe. And it's kind of like a family trait that y'all all share.
And we want people to feel like they're part of us, you know.
Right.
I don't care if they come shopping in their pajamas. It doesn't matter to me. I just want them to feel at home.
Hey, yeah.
That's what it's about to me.
That is great. Now, where is Backstage Boutique located?
We're on 157 in the same building as the Premier Bank.
Okay.
Okay. So.
Very neat.
We've been there, it'll be a year this October.
Mm-hmm.
And we have almost 2,000 square feet in there, so that's a lot. I know when we started putting it together, we thought we would never build this place. And now we're looking for areas to put other things in there.
Oh, yeah.
So it's just really blown out. But this year has been remarkably better than we ever thought it would be. So we're really excited about the upcoming season, Christmas and everything like that. So I think it's gonna go forward.
Awesome, very nice. Well, where do y'all go to find your stuff that you put in your store?
Well, we try to stay away from local markets, but we've been all over the United States, really. And we do order some things, but we don't like to do that because we actually like to hand select because the styles are made so different. The material is not as nice as you think it is when you just order it online, and some of them are cut smaller. And that is a problem you have with boutique clothing, you know,
they're
cut smaller. So we've been to New York, to L.A., to Vegas, and even in the state of Alabama, we have vendors that we have bought from. We try to stay different because the local boutiques have awesome fashions also, but we like to stay a little bit different if we can, and we do have some things that they have. I guess that's inevitable, but we just want to be able to find something different, and that way we can all have good business.
Yeah, that's awesome that you guys support each other and don't try to directly compete by having, you know, similar or the same styles. That's a good network style to have.
It's worked well for us. And if we do hear anything when people come in, they like it because we have different things. Our price range is really well. And we hope that we can find things for them. We do look for specific things if someone is looking for something. And we also have a business in Pelham. It's not our business, but we have our clothing in a business there. So if we don't have the size or the style they want, we can check and see if we got it there. So if
that's great. It. So if I came in and I said, hey, you know, I was looking for something like this, you guys wouldn't be opposed to ordering something like that? That's pretty cool.
I spend a lot of my time looking for specific items for people that just maybe not necessarily said that they were going to buy it, but that they would like to have it. And
yeah.
So if it's there, they're not obligated to take it, but uh-huh. it's there if they want it.
Yeah, and the fact that you guys kind of hand select as opposed to just ordering right. in bulk online showcases your quality and work ethic toward that. So
we
that's
do that.
Great.
We do. We hand select everything, and if it's not something that I would like to see on my family or someone in my family, I don't get it.
That's so. Great. Huh. Well, what are you thinking about all this?
You know, I've never been much of a boutique guy because they don't have a lot of men's yeah. boutiques or that kind of thing. But, you know, I do have younger sisters, and I do have, you know, my mother, and she loves to shop at these places. So I'm always intrigued when I walk into a boutique because, well, number one, originality. You never see a lot of the same things mm-hmm. that you would find in normal retail stores because they're not being mass-produced. And I kind of like that homegrown feel. And I've actually been to you guys' store with family, two younger niece or cousins, and they have purchased from you. So I personally like the store. I actually do like the theme behind it. The biggest thing that I was always wondering about is that how often do you find people who come in and try to give you things that they've made?
Actually, we've had several that would, you know, come by and maybe make hand soaps or something like that. And actually, through the Christmas season, we plan to carry mm-hmm. more gift items where people, you know, just a last-minute thing they might see. And we're also opening up to layaways for Christmas. And
oh, that's nice.
That will help. We're a little limited on space to store it, but we're going to make it work mm-hmm. this year.
That's exciting. So how would that layaway plan work for people, and when would it be in effect?
Well, probably after this, we have two buying trips already set up for the rest of the year. And after we get back from the first one, we're leaving the 11th and of September. And when we get back, we'll probably start it in effect. We'll have to have some pretty strict rules about it because, you know, we can't just let it lay there from September till December, you know.
No.
But, you know, people work with us, and we try to make people happy. I mean, there's been some, I'm sure, that's not been happy, but we really try
right.
to make it work.
Yeah. Well, that's exciting. That's very cool. That's a wonderful option for people that are kind of having to buy for several people at
right.
once.
Right.
To just have to, you know, give a little bit here, give a little bit there. I know my sister is the queen of purchasing for, like, all of her boys and her family and everything. And she's got it worked out to where she just pays a tiny bit here at this store, a tiny bit here at this store. So.
And that works very well.
I
believe you can have more quality mm-hmm. gifts that way.
I agree, definitely. So do y'all have any favorite items that you've brought with you today?
We have mm-hmm. such a wide selection. Honestly, our jewelry section is probably as large as most of your department stores. I'm serious.
Oh, that's crazy. Mm-hmm.
So we have things from leather to rhinestones. We have denim clothing. We have the dress extenders. We have candles. We have it's just too numerous. There's no way we could have bought. But we have our price range. We try to keep everything seriously. Probably 95% at least is below $50.
Yes.
We have a line that we get that is Italian made, and it's got Italian silk in it, and it's the priciest thing we have. And it sort of sets up front when people come in, they look at that first, it's like, oh, you know.
Yes.
But that's the only thing. I mean, that line. And actually right now no one in Alabama has that line. They will, but no one has that.
Okay, mm-hmm. That's pretty neat. Now, what kind of things do this line make?
Well, that is one of them,
on the blue,
and the leggings also. They have a silk blend to them. They mm-hmm. are made in Italy, and we have met the young man who is responsible for the designs, and we went one time, went back 3 months later, and he had 5 locations, so he is really going forward with it.
That's
his
great.
Styles. So that's why I say they will be here.
Yeah. Well, obviously, you know, fall is coming up. I think it starts like September 20th or something like that. Officially kicking off fall, my favorite time. Yeah. He hates fall. He hates anything that's
it's
not
cold.
Summer.
If it's cold, it's not worth being.
I like fall. Do y'all have any suggestions for fall style that you would like to throw out there for these Cullman ladies?
It seems like the capes and all
the
are
capes
staying
and denim. And denim. And layering is going to be big this season. She's purchased a lot of things with the smoky blue color, so that's going to be big for this season.
And boots are going to be. It just seems to roll over, you know.
Yeah.
They'll change a little bit here and there, but, you know. And actually, a lot of times we here in the South are the last to get the West Coast styles that come out. And
right.
I hate that, but we do.
Right.
You know, we're a little lagging sometimes. It doesn't catch on. I found it better now than it has been.
I agree, yeah, definitely. I feel like those New York and West Coast styles come to us quicker now than, say, when I was in high school. I would try to wear something that I saw on TV and people would just...
People think you were a freak.
Yeah, they really did, yeah. And I was like, well, you know what, I'm still just going to wear it.
So. Exactly.
Yeah.
That's what we need to be as individual.
So
we've been blessed. God has blessed our business.
Wonderful. Well, how can people get in touch with you? I know you've already stated your location. Can you give us your phone number? Do you have a Facebook page?
We do have a Facebook, but it's Backstage Boutique, BHM. We couldn't do away with the BHM. It's the Birmingham Airport code because we would have lost all of our contacts from Birmingham.
Okay.
So, yes, we'd like from the going. We're having a like and share right now because we're having a big sale Saturday.
Okay. And where can they call y'all at?
They call Alicia.
Yes.
She's the one that will be there.
Okay.
735. Oh, gosh.
I can't remember.
4336.
Yes,
I'm sorry. I went blank.
That's okay. Plus, we all know how to use Google, I would hope.
Right.
So.
Yes.
Well, now our hours, we're there Tuesday through Saturday. But Saturday, only 10 to 3 right now, and till 7 on Friday night. But those hours will be extended through the holiday season.
Okay, wonderful. Well, we look forward to hearing more about all of these upcoming things that y'all are doing.
Thank you for having us.
Of course. Thank you guys for coming.
I feel like a bass singer, but
y'all are doing great, and y'all look beautiful, and thank you for coming
thank
on.
You. Nice to see you.
So, again, we do appreciate you coming on the show. We're excited to see where the store continues to go. And if you ever want to come back on and let us know how things are going, we would
definitely let us know.
Thank you.
Well, if you will join us again in just a moment, we will be right back.
That's how fast the health information technology profession is projected to grow this decade. That's how much a health information technician can make in the first year. Who will you be? Be one of us and get in a Wallace state of mind.
Have you been online to see our brand new website? Go to mycullmantv.com. There you can find links to see a live stream, notes from today's shows, you can meet our sponsors, and even meet us here at the station. But don't forget about that Meet the Sponsors link. There you can see advertisements from the sponsors that help keep us on the air. You can also click on the links to go to these sponsors' web pages. My Cullman Television. Let's discover Cullman together.
Life lived in black and white is not a life lived. Today, I choose color. To see it. To feel it. To be in it. To be upon it. And to live a life surrounded by it. Today, I put on a fresh coat.
And welcome back. So, you know, we were just talking to that wonderful, wonderful store. And, you know, they have some awesome stuff to give out.
Uh-huh.
And I always use this as a segue because I like to think that we as community members also like to give awesome things to people.
Well, who wouldn't want to get something awesome?
Well, yeah, see, and that's exactly my point, is that why are people not calling us? Why have you not called us yet to win some awesome prizes? Because they
you
are indeed
why?
Awesome.
Because you sound like Ben Nye today or somebody.
Well, I can't help it. Okay.
I mean, perk up. I know it's Monday, but hey, I'm going to give you some coffee.
Yeah, I'm going to need it. It's going to be a long day. For everybody, it's a Monday, and it's a gloomy Monday too.
And
that
I'm actually help. Excited about this Monday. I don't know.
See,
why.
I don't know if we'd woken up and we'd stepped outside and the sun was shining and smiling and the birds were chirping.
Listen, yeah, this isn't Cinderella, and you're not gonna have little birds fly around.
Now, listen here, ma'am. I can hope and dream. But and you know we do want to give you some awesome prizes, but we need you to call in and tell us who the Facebook sponsor of the day indeed was. So I'm gonna give you a hint in the off chance that you haven't been able to reach Facebook. Or, you know, just are on your way to work or something like that. So today's hint is which one of our sponsors has been providing insurance for over three generations? Which of our sponsors has provided insurance for three generations? Call us at 256-734-7399. Let us know, and you could win those awesome prizes. Alrighty. Well, we've gotten a lot of interesting things going on in the world of news today. Mainly some highlighted points of the community, so we'll start right off. In Atlanta, a man died after he fell from the upper deck at Turner Field during a Braves game. This is one of my biggest fears. If I could state anything off the top of my head that I have a phobia of, it's not me in heights, it's others in heights. I can't watch
you know
people
what?
Near
after
large
doing
falls.
My little experiment last week with the ropes course, I've decided I'm terribly afraid of heights as well. Gregory Murray, he was 60 years old of Alpharetta, Georgia. He stumbled out of the stands during the seventh inning of the Braves-Yankees game. Police are still trying to determine what caused his fall, but foul play is not suspected. He fell head over feet and hit the concrete walkway in front of a row of fans. He hit some lines attached to the backstop as he fell. Paramedics worked on him for several minutes before they took him away on a stretcher.
The game did continue, and fans were escorted out around the area he fell. Murray did love the Atlanta Braves. He was a season ticket holder with the same seats for 23 years. 23 years in the same area.
That is just so unfortunate. I can't imagine being present at the game if that, you know, had happened around me. I surely would not have been able to
That view would have just destroyed me in terms of wanting to ever go to a baseball game again. Anywhere in the nosebleed section, that always worries me, especially with kids.
Right. Well, you know, we send condolences out to his family, but, you know, that is just sad. But in other news, President Obama is renaming Mount McKinley. So, if you guys have grown up knowing that Mount McKinley is the tallest North American mountain peak, get used to calling it a new name, and its new name is going to be
Denali.
The Native Alaskan name Denali.
Yep. Obama will visit Alaska next week, where he will gather support for ways to slow climate change. A prospector named the mountains after William McKinley after learning he became a U.S. presidential candidate in 1896. McKinley became the country's 25th president. He was, though, assassinated 6 months into his second term.
Mm-hmm. And the peaks were previously called Denali by the Native Alaskan tribe, so the site has significant cultural importance to Alaska Natives, so maybe restoring it to its original name may have a greater effect than Mount McKinley.
Absolutely. And in local news, a 21-year-old man died in a car accident on Convent Road. Now, the Cullman County Coroner Jeremy O'Kilpatrick pronounced Wyatt Hurd dead at the scene of a two-car motor vehicle accident yesterday. He collided with another car near the bridge overlooking Bridge Creek near the Cullman Animal Shelter, which is not that far from here. The second party was transported to Cullman Regional Medical Center. There, their medical status currently is unknown. Cullman Police Department will not release any further details until they have fully investigated the accident. So we're not sure what caused the accident. We're not sure if the second person involved is current state, but we will keep you updated as we find out more. This is terrible, but with this weather the way it's been, I mean, it surprises me that there honestly hasn't been more accidents.
Yeah, I mean, even just the other day, whenever it did pour pretty hard that one day, I remember I was driving in, you know how the right side of the road always like catches all of the water? And if you drive through it, you know, your tires just kind of can't help but, you know,
hydroplane
suck it up
all over
and
the place.
Yeah, basically almost hydroplane. So Definitely, you can't be safe enough. The weather is still deciding if it wants to be summer or if it wants to be fall. So just be safe out there and stay well. Don't be like me and you know, be under the weather a lot of the time. So.
And again, when it comes to your vehicle, remember proper maintenance close to home here. I mean, with tires are important.
Yeah.
Definitely make sure that the tread on those are good. Mm-hmm. You want to constantly make sure that you have updated windshield wipers. The maintenance on those on your vehicle is important, and it can really save not only your life but the lives of the people driving around
you.
Neglect can seriously hurt you, so definitely keep up with not only your own health but the, you know, the safety of others through your vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty, well now I'm going to perk up a little bit because it's now time for my favorite part of the show, and that is indeed the part where I get to talk about the weather. So let's take a look at that. And again, that is brought to you by Mitch Smith Chevrolet. So make the switch to Mitch. Alrighty, the average high for today is going to be 90, with the average low for the day at 69 degrees. Record high was set in 1937 at 103, with a record low at 1974 at 52 degrees. Yeesh. Sunset tonight at 8.07 p.m. with sunrise tomorrow and a bright and sunny 5.37 a.m. Now, it says that we have this beautiful big clear spot, but as you can tell, that weird Gulf pressure is still happening over there, so definitely keep an eye out. We never know when these pop-up showers are going to come down from the north or from the south. Again, the high of 80, looking at the high for today, looking at about 83 with a chance of rain at 10%. Tonight, still a 10% chance of rain with a low of 67, that high. And we're looking at 87 tomorrow with a 20% chance of rain. So again, we've got a rainy week looking, some chances of rain here and there. It looks like we're staying about the upper 80s to low 80s throughout the week. And again, the mid to upper 60s for the lows. So mostly cloudy and sunny throughout the week with small chances of rain here and there. So we could either have a potentially very rainy week or very sunny week. This is one of those toss-ups. So bring the umbrella with you anyway. It always helps. That's
yeah.
All I can say.
Oh, yeah.
Pack
never,
warm.
Never hurts to be on the sick side.
Dress warm and dry. Mm-hmm. Just wear double socks. Do something. Alrighty. Well, again, if you will join us in just a moment, we will be right back.
Fire, accident, storm. They all happen in Cullman County, and for three generations, Knight Free Insurance has been there for you. Continuing today with Elliott and Westcott Free, customizing your life, home, auto, and business insurance with companies like Auto Owners, State Auto, and Southern Guarantee. Call Westcott, Elliott, Judy, Tina, Angie, or Nelda. Knight Free Insurance, where people are the difference.
Hi, I'm Jay Mullins with Premier Bank.
And I'm Jacob Mullins.
For more than 26 years, we've been providing friendly personal banking services to the citizens of Cullman and surrounding counties. We continue to provide new and improved services to our customers, and we even have a new look. So come by and see us at any of our 9 convenient locations. And remember, the same friendly personal service, and we're open on Saturdays.
It was a moment that changed my life. I'd been training with my team for months, and now we had been called up for the first time. The real deal. Wildfires were getting dangerously close to homes. At that moment, I got my first taste of just how important the Guard is to my community.
See how the Guard can be an important part of your life at NationalGuard.com.
And we are back with our community billboards, sponsored by Pepsi. And we have the 19th annual Sweet Tater Festival, which is going to be held on Labor Day weekend, September 5th, 6th, and 7th at Smith Lake Park. And admission will be $3. You can contact the Smith Lake Park office for more info.
And the cookbook fundraiser brought to you by the Women of Faith Group, Garden City Church of God. This is still continuing. Again, these are $12.50 each, and the proceeds benefit the church's food bank. For more information, you can contact Ms. Rhonda Davis or Patsy Kennedy.
And don't forget to reach out to Ms. Catherine Morgan at State Farm. She has wonderful savings. And the Candlelight Walking Tours will be October 5th and October 6th, 2015. These are guided tours through downtown Cullman. They begin at the Cullman County Museum and the Fest Hall Market Plots. For more information, visit CullmanOctoberfest.com.
And the Alabama Gourd Festival is October 17th and 18th. They are located at the Cullman Civic Center, and the admission is $3. Kids 12 and under, though, are free. For more information, visit www.alabamagourdsociety.org.
And the rummage sale put on by the Cullman Pilot Club will be October 23rd and 24th at the Cullman Fairgrounds. We are definitely looking forward to going out there and seeing what those ladies have.
And Ben South's One-Liner Diner on the Southern Humor Highway, brought to you by Red Door Cafe. And this is again here in Cullman, and it's every Saturday except for this Labor Day Saturday, and is highlighting the various important members of the humor community here in the South. So definitely stop by and check that out.
And if you have a community billboard, just let us know. You can visit us online at mycullmantv.com or send us an email at mycullmantv@gmail.com or give us a call at 256-734-7399. And please make sure that you like us on Facebook at My Cullman Television. And again, we are sponsored by Pepsi. And wishing you a happy birthday today, Mr. Jay Page, for this Monday. And don't forget, we're going to do that weekly drawing on Friday, and whoever will win will receive an ice cream cake from Dairy Queen. And send us your anniversary so that we can do a drawing for a $15 gift certificate from the Candle Garden this Friday as well.
Alrighty, well, if you didn't already know, our sponsor of the day was indeed Knight Free Insurance Agency, providing you insurance coverage for over three generations. So definitely give them a call. And again, like us on Facebook, check us out. We want to hear from you. If you have any comments or questions, we are here to answer them. And if you have any stories or things that you'd like to hear more about, definitely let us know. We are always interested in figuring out what you would like to know.
Yes.
Alrighty, well, we mentioned something briefly just a moment ago, and I would really like to kind of cover it a little bit more in depth,
because
it is important to us. That would be the Sweet Potato Festival that goes on every year here in the Cullman area.
Yeah, you know, I went to the Sweet Tater Festival last year, and, you know, it's just always such a great time. It's very family-friendly, and they have some of the best vendors that I've seen, so I'm really excited to get out there, and, of course, the sweet potatoes. Who doesn't love those?
I'm telling you, a good sweet potato french fry is the best.
Yeah, it is.
It's the best. Now, there are many events going on this year, including the door prizes, the arts and crafts, the various food vendors that they always have, the kitty rides, and indeed the street rod car show that they're having this year. So there's going to be a lot of entertainment there, tons of things that you can go and do.
Yeah, and so it says become a vendor. Let's see. Well, I don't know if they're still taking vendors, but if y'all wanted to try, you could always call Smith Lake Park office at 256-739-2916 and find out the status of that. Those sweet potatoes are donated by the Cullman County Sweet Potato Growers. So all of those sweet potatoes are local, homegrown, and they are awesome.
Absolutely. And again, this is at Smith Lake Park.
I
was just talking about it. I remember the time that it was held in Crane Hill, but
yeah,
it's not this year, and last year it was not either. It is, again, at Smith Lake Park, and they have facilities that can offer for camping, pavilion, cabins, motorhomes. They've got a lot of stuff going on over there. If you've never been there, it's a wonderful area.
It really is. And, I mean, I can't rave about the food and the vendors enough. I found one of my favorite rings there that I wear a lot. So just the quality of everything that they have to offer is really up to par. And so we really want to urge everyone to come out and attend that. You know, it's only held once a year on Labor Day weekend. Gives you something to do for Labor Day if you're staying home or if, you know, you don't have plans out on the lake or anything.
Absolutely. So you definitely want to check that out. It's a great community event that you do not want to miss. Can't stress that enough. Sweet Potato Festival is always a good time.
Yes.
All righty. Well, we've got an interesting show going on tomorrow.
Yes, we do.
Not sure how to describe my feelings towards this particular subject, but we do have some guests coming on to talk about some cool things with us. It's Mr. Gene Holt and God Holt. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. It's G-O-D-D. You know who you are. So hopefully I didn't butcher your name too bad. But they are coming on to talk to us tomorrow, so I'm excited to see what that's about.
Me too. Alrighty. Well, you know what? I say this just about every Monday, almost like you say it about the weather. May your Monday be short and your coffee be strong.
Because trust me, we're all going to need it if it stays like this. Absolutely. Well, again, I'm Jacob Murphy.
I'm Natalie Bonner.
And again, everyone here at My Cullman Television, I hope you have a great Monday, and we'll see you in the morning.